Hi, this is Karen Greenhouse, and today I'm actually going to compare three Casio graphing calculators so that you can see similarities and differences, so that when you're trying to decide which one to buy, you kind of can make an educated decision. So we've got the three, the Prizm on the left, the 9860 in the center, and the 9750 on the right. One major difference is the Casio Prizm's in color, but you'll see that for the most part they have the same layouts. The calculators are a different size, so they're maybe more condensed, but they have the menu options. They have, and the Prizm has a couple more menu options than the other two on the right, but for the most part, functionality is pretty much the same. Bigger calculator, more memory with the Prizm, color with the Prizm, but the functionality, we're gonna do an example here to show you that the functionality of the three of them is very, very similar. So we're just entering two functions here. You'll see we basically go through the exact same process. One of the nice things about Casio calculators is if you know the buttons and you switch the calculator, you're still gonna know how to perform all the activities that you need. The skills, they don't change with the calculators. So we've entered the calculators, the functions, and now we're gonna graph. So you'll see the graphs are the same, and yet they look different because of the size of the screens. That's one difference, is there are different size screens. But you'll notice we're going to show the intersection that we get the same menu options across the bottom by hitting function 5. I'm going to solve, I'm going to find the intersections, and you'll notice that in all three I can toggle between the two intersections in this particular example. The difference with the Casio Prizm is that I can actually set those points and show the coordinates on the screen, and I actually see my two graphs in different colors because of the color menu. But functionality wise they're pretty much the same. You'll notice now we're just going to get rid of those two functions. We do the same process on all three calculators. Hit delete function 1, yes. The reason I'm doing this is to show you that there's an additional feature on the Prizm which is called the modify feature. And this is not available on the other two calculators, but it's a great function. There's also this tool menu that provides some built-in functions that you'll notice are variables for the coefficients. So we're going to show you how the modify feature works. We're going to choose one of these functions and we're going to hit the modify button. And you'll notice on the left that I have the variables for those coefficients, and I can now change them one at a time by using my toggle key, and you'll see that it allows the function to change and show what that particular coefficient is doing, how it's impacting it. This is because of the memory on the Prizm. So the Prizm's memory is much more, it's compared to the other two, so it's able to do these types of kind of dynamic mathematics. So you'll see I can enter numbers and it changes. So this is a really nice feature on the Prizm. So if this is important to you, the Prizm might be the one to go with. Obviously, things you need to think about are, do you want color? What size screen do you want? Do you want more memory? So you would go with the Prizm on those cases. But functionality-wise, for the most part, they all perform the same. So let's go back to the menu. You'll notice we're back in the main menu for all of them. We're going to go and show you another feature that some of them have and some of them don't. The first two calculators, the Prizm and the 9860, show fractions, irrational numbers in their natural display, meaning they actually look like fractions, whereas the 9750 does not have that feature because of its memory capability. So you enter the fractions different, but once you have the fraction in all three calculators, you can toggle between decimal and fraction form. But the first two calculators have that natural display that the third calculator does not have. So if that's important to you, then you might choose the first two options as your calculator. So obviously there's a lot of decisions to make. Cost might be an element. So obviously it goes from more affordable from the right to the left. But check out all the features on CasioEducation.com.